Today we out here shilling for dive blue Nemo. Now, I don't see a single clownfish on this, so I don't see how they got copyright from Disney. So, good luck with that lawsuit there, dive blue people.
If you do want to buy one of these dive blue Nemo systems, there is a link in the description below. We make a small commission from it, which really helps out the channel. Well, I do.
Yeah, I don't get nothing from this. Nemo, pay me.
One of the reasons why I love this location is because of the visibility. It's like 6 or 7 feet today. We're already finding bone. Today might be a really good day. We gotta cover some ground and find some more fossils. So this is the first bend we've checked today, and it has a really good bone density. We just found something really cool. This is my first capybara molar. So this is the largest rodent that still exists. It's called a capybara. They were native here in Florida, and that's a single tooth from these huge animals. So that's a really good sign. We got a lot of fossil bone as well, including this ankle bone, and the rest of this is mainly just tortoise shell and then some shark teeth from the underlying Miocene, early Miocene sediments. So
you're telling me them capybaras retired to South America?
Yeah, these capybaras retired to South America, but I want to get back in there, and I cannot wait to keep finding some stuff. Wow, that is a nice sloth tooth. Like a dream. You and me. That's a very big piece of leg. Whew. What's going on here? Woo! A big old animal died here. Look at that ball joint. That thing is huge. This is pretty cool. Yeah, big old ball joint. Let's go put it with the rest of the stuff that we found in the past couple bends. We've been diving for maybe an hour or two,
and we found
4 hours?
We've been out here for 4 hours, dude.
Wow.
Yeah.
We've got some really awesome stuff. We're gonna have lunch, and we're gonna keep moving on. We did manage to find a lot of stuff. We've got giant ground sloth, tapir, eagle, extinct horse, giant tortoise, and all of this bone that we just recovered. And even though we don't know exactly what species it is, because we didn't find any teeth, we do know it's a giant elephant, either a mammoth or a mastodon, based off of this honeycomb structure. So this is a piece of the skull. And the skull has this honeycomb structure in these large animals to reduce weight, but keep the structural integrity. If this was solid bone instead of these pockets of air, a mammoth or a mastodon would not be able to carry its own head. It would weigh way too much for it to be able to move around. But I love spots like this that have such a unique diversity of species and some rare fossils as well. This giant ground sloth
tooth is a canine, and you can see this shear pattern from it chewing hundreds of pounds of food every day. And then we've got this little tiny eagle claw, some type of raptor. They're incredibly rare, and I've only ever found the third one, so I'm really thankful for that. We're gonna get moving. We've got a lot more stuff that we could find today, and we've gotta get back underwater. What'd you find?
I chilled on the bank, and then I hopped in one spot, and I found a chunk of elephant tusk, probably mastodon.
That's pretty cool. It's got the cross hatching. It's super cooked. Clink it against your teeth.
No, you just want me to lose a tooth.
Well, then I'll find it.
Oh.
Ugh, it gives you shivers. Mm. Good stuff.
And I found this right next to it. But the rest of that hole was all sand, so if it ever gets a little bit shallower, it'll wash out some teeth, probably.
Hopefully.
Hope one would think, you know.
All right, let's get back to hiking. We found a new bend in the river to check. It's really interesting. The water is a bit higher than what we're used to out here. And so different parts of this river are exposing gravel and bone that we normally wouldn't find. So we're gonna try to keep finding some stuff. We don't got a lot of day left.
It's also like January, so I am done. I am like up on the bank. I am cold. I am warming up now. If you wanna freeze your hind end off, you can contact John at whatever his phone number is and pay a crap ton of money for the replace me auction that he's going to be having.
Joe's gonna be my dive buddy for a long time still. Don't you worry.
Nah, I'm going home.
I'm getting back underwater.
I'm going home.
So I haven't been in this bend for too long, and it's about 8 feet deep right here. I'm standing on top of a fallen log, but there's a really nice extinct taper teeth. I'm gonna go down, get it, and show you guys. That's killer. So that's an extinct tapir that used to be here in Florida. Tapirus varroensis, most likely. But they're only in South America right now. As Joe said, they've retired there.
Falling upstairs.
It's a really good tooth, though. So hopefully we can find some more stuff like this as I finish this bend. I just popped out of this hole. It's about 9 feet deep. And the first thing I noticed was this really nice horse tooth. But we've got a condyle to a man with a mastodon skull. So that's really cool. We've been finding a lot of skull elements and teeth today. It's just a matter of time. It might not be today, it might be the next time we come out, but we'll find either a man with a mastodon tooth in this river. I'm sure about it. But it's a really cool bone.
Haven't we already found sloughs of mammoth and mastodon teeth in this river?
A few of them, but I want a few more, don't you?
I only have like one whole one from this river. But then again, I don't try that hard.
So those last two bends had a ton of peat, which is a really good sign, but it was almost entirely giant tortoise. We got that horse tooth and that condyle piece to a man with the mastodon skull, but we gotta keep moving. We might find something else today. Only thing we can do is keep trying. It is cold though, and I do not blame Joe for getting out. There's a bathtub over in the woods somewhere to our left.
Somebody taking a redneck bath?
Something like that. It's not the first one I found out in these rivers, too. I found
random. You almost said the name of the river.
Ooh.
Ooh.
But no, seriously, I found plenty of bathtubs randomly out in the middle of the woods near rivers before. And I don't get it. Do they float? Are they good boats? The world may never know.
It's 50 bucks or else I tell the name of the river.
25.
40.
Deal.
All right.
It was just sand over here, but there is some peat and gravel over here. I'm hoping that it opens up as we get further to the bend, but it might just be a sandy bend. We'll have to see. But it's cold!
Yeah, and there's probably a gator in there too.
Shut up. There wasn't a gator so far, but there was a really nice gator tooth. So here's hoping there's more fossils in there.
Mm-hmm.
All we managed to get from there was that single gator tooth. But we're gonna hike and find something else while we still have a little bit of sun left to play with.
I'm just a stuff bringer.
You're so slow. Cool area.
I've been demoted from fossil hunting buddy to stuff carrier.
You chose that life.
I feel a lot better now.
Good. So Joe over here is trying to not talk about fossils, but that's what we're out here to do,
buddy.
You
gotta delete that part. That was
weird. Yeah, I'm not gonna show it.
That was weird as hell.
I'm gonna get underwater over here and see if we can't find something more.
Look at that chunk of giant tortoise.
John just threw up this here chunk of tortoise shell. Pretty big old solid chunk. That's usually a good sign. You can see that's obviously a bit of tortoise. But he got a lot more tortoise under that log, I guess.
There's a ton of bone. It's opened up. And I'm hoping that besides the giant tortoise bone that's in here, there might be something else, like another tooth or something. But I gotta get back underwater and see. It's getting cold. It's getting late, but this could be a good spot.
Probably all tortoise.
We are starting to get more diversity. That's another extinct horse tooth from an older individual, wore down most of the tooth, and then I got a little gator tooth next to it. So I'm gonna get back underwater, hand these off to Joe.
That's all you keep me for, huh? Just to sit on the bank and mind your stuff?
Mind my fossils, Joe.
Oh, you about said something else.
Stuff. This spot down there is really sketchy though, because you see these falling down palm fronds? They're on the bottom, and so you have to like push through them, and you have no idea what's there. So it's pretty sketchy, to be honest.
Yeah, that's kind of like where I put Steve on a gator a couple years ago.
And yet you still haven't gotten a gator yourself.
No, I'm good at putting people on them, though.
All right, well.
That was a lot more shallow, though. I doubt there's anything in there.
I hope.
Yeah, that was a gator, and there's fossils there, so I'm gonna go back underwater and try not to piss it off, and hopefully it'll let me grab those rocks, so see what happens.
We shall see. I'll grab your phone to call the helicopter. You get them?
Oh, let me grab the bones. I've got a
thingy check.
Acid on toe bone right here, which it looks actually completely whole, which is a new position for me. I love getting these toe bones. Eventually you want to composite a foot, but that is a complete toe bone, and then a huge piece of giant tortoise. So I didn't see the third bone, but I'm gonna move forward and get out of his way and find some more stuff if there's any. If not, we found a lot of cool stuff today, and I don't mind wrapping it up.
John, in his infinite know-it-allness, misidentified something. If you look right there at that surface, that radiating pattern right there, and that surface right there, that's actually an unfused juvenile neck vertebrae of an elephant. Yeah, that's definitely a neck vertebrae, because look, those are the little holes on the side. Turtle shell would have the cross-section of the, you know, the meat on that side, and it wouldn't have this pattern. That's an unfused neck vertebrae. Pretty beat up, but
that's what it is.
You were wrong.
I'm sorry. It was dark in there.
You're supposed to be like educating people and you can't even get your rocks right. Come on now. You have a 4-year degree, 5-year degree. I know how long it took you to finish college. It's cool. He got a double major in like environmental, whatever.
All right, it is dark. We just ran into a gator, found some more fossils. We're basically done. We just got to wrap up, hike out of here, and get dry and fossil another day. So thank you guys so much for watching this week's video. If you like it, please share and subscribe to the channel. And as always, keep on digging science.
Not gonna plug your giveaway? Not gonna shield your Nemo?
Oh,
you're a terrible
right,
Nemo
right,
shill.
Right. We always shield the Nemo.
Oh, Nemo, pay me.
We are doing something new on the channel though. We are giving away something in every new video we publish. So go check out our Facebook page, linked in the description below, for this video's giveaway.
John's giving away a lightly used Nemo.
No.
Probably gonna be mine.
Keeps talking like that.
That thing's gonna like draw down all the gators in mating season. One negative review. It sounds like a very
aggressive gator.
Edgy, anxious. Not that I know what gator are.
All right, guys, we're done. As always, keep on digging science. See ya.